Hi, my name is Kristen and I'm a registered physiotherapist. Welcome to this movement practice to help release tension around the neck, shoulders, and upper body. We'll be using no equipment today, but a variety of sensory inputs with tapping and muscle squeezing and shaking. The sensory inputs help to stimulate the sensory system to release holding tension, as well as to improve circulation to muscles that may have gotten stuck in a prolonged posture or a repetitive movement. As always, please move within your comfort zone. We're trying to decrease tension in muscles that might have gotten tight from holding, protecting against pain. We're not trying to aggravate your typical pain. So move within your comfort zone and take a break as needed, and maybe pick and choose the movements that feel best for you. So before we begin, it's a good idea just to take a moment to notice where you're at to start with. Noticing your posture, how do your shoulders feel? Are they up around your ears or relaxed downward? Taking a maybe a moment to notice your movement. So a little bit of a neck turn. How does it feel to turn your head? How far do you go? And if there's any resistance or ease there. And raising an arm up and lowering it down. Again, noticing how far you go and the sense of that, if there's any resistance or if it moves easily. So to begin our practice, we'll start with some tapping. Just using your fingertips, starting tapping around your chest, around the sternum. And maybe you can hear a little bit of a vibration in my voice. I'm trying to create a little bit of that vibration that stimulates those sensory nerves, especially in the fascia and connective tissue. Just a gentle tapping that feels okay for you around the ribs and the sternum here. You can bring that down around the lower part of the ribs, around where the diaphragm attaches. A little bit of tapping there. You can be doing this from a seated position or standing. Great way to take a break in the day if you're sitting at a desk, working on both sides. Just a gentle tap there. Feeling that vibration. You can tap on both sides. Or you can even give yourself a hug and tap on both sides that way. That feels better for your shoulders. Good job. Then we'll bring our tapping up to one shoulder here. And just a slight cupped palm tapping towards my shoulder. And I'll start tapping down my front of my arm to the palm of the hand. And up the back of the hand, the back of the arm, to the back of the shoulder. Do that a couple more times. And you should feel just a little bit of a sensory tingling happening. Something just very light. Again, this helps to wake up those sensory nerves and helps them release holding tension, as well as bringing in some circulation to some areas that may have just got a little bit stagnant. One more time. Good job. Just light tapping. And then the next time you land up at your shoulder, we'll do some muscle sponging. So breathe in, shrug your shoulder up into your hand and give it a little squeeze, like you're squeezing out the water from a sponge. And breathe out, letting it relax downward. Imagine that sponge filling. Breathe in, squeeze up, and breathe out, lower down. We'll do this a few more times. And contracting the muscle, giving it a squeeze, and then letting it fill. This pumping action can help improve some circulation. Most of us hold some degree of tension up around our upper trap here. Breathe in, squeeze up, and breathe out, release. One more time. Good job. And we'll finish with just some stroking. Imagine you've loosened up all of that tension and you're just brushing it off your body, stroking down your arm and off the tips of your fingertips. Good job. Now we'll do the other side, a little bit of light tapping here to the front of the shoulder. And then working down the front of the arm to the palm of the hand, around the back of the hand, to the back of the forearm, the back of the shoulder. A little bit of a light tap so you feel that sensory type of tingling. Again, you're not trying to aggravate your pain. It should be staying around its baseline. All the way down to the palm of the hand and back up to the shoulder. Next time you land at the shoulder, we'll do our muscle sponging. Imagine your upper trap as a sponge. Breathe in, shrug it up, squeeze it out, and breathe out, imagining it filling up with fresh, clean water, fresh, clean circulation. Breathing in, shrugging up, squeezing that upper trap, and breathe out, releasing it. Good job. We'll do one more. And then letting that go. And then we can do just a little bit of shaking. If you're standing, you can kind of bounce your body a little bit. And you can just kind of shake out your arms. And you can even imagine kind of shaking and then kind of flicking water off your hands. Loosening up your hands, loosening up your body, shaking, and maybe even flicking. So we had some water on you and flick it off. Good. One more time. So that should help to loosen up and get some circulation into our hands and our arms. Now we'll work a little bit more with releasing tension from the neck. I'm going to turn my back to you so that you can see what I'm doing. So taking both hands, if you're able to, you can have them just kind of massaging on either side of your spine. Massaging all the way up to the base of your skull. Lots of muscles attached there, and they tend to get a little bit stiff or tight. You can start to kind of nod your chin down as you're massaging and tip your chin up as you massage the base of the skull. Do what feels best for you. Take a break if those arms are getting tired. There are ways to use massage balls for this area if it's not accessible with your hands. And then we'll work through the middle of the neck. You can take one hand, laying it across the back of the neck, and then turning your head towards that arm, that hand, as you rake your hands across to massage those muscles. So I like to do some breathing with this, breathing in and out as you turn and rake across. Breathe in, reset, breathe out, turn towards and rake across. A couple more times here. And stay within your comfort zone. You don't have to do a big turn. And what you're trying to do is keep your pain around that baseline, not trying to aggravate it, trying to loosen up some other areas maybe in the neighborhood. One more. And then we'll do the other side. Lay your hand across the back of your neck. Turn your head towards your hand and rake the hand across to those muscles at the side of your neck to help them massage, bring some circulation. Breathing in and out as you turn. Just a small movement, a small neck turn, doesn't have to be all the way. And as always, staying within your comfort zone. One more time. Good job. And you can return to your start position. I'm sitting on my bolster here. And then just take a moment to notice your posture. How does it feel? Do your shoulders feel up around your ears, or do they feel a little bit more relaxed now? Maybe checking your neck turn. Do you feel like you're moving further, or maybe you feel like there's more ease to that movement, less resistance? Checking in with your arm raise. How does that feel? Right to left, and do you notice the difference between then and now? Is there a little bit more movement, or is there a bit more ease to that movement? My hope for you is that you did find more movement or more ease or just generally better posture, feeling more relaxed, feeling maybe that your muscles are a little bit more awake or alive. Those are all good things. And if you didn't feel very good with this practice, then maybe modifying for next time or choosing something different, like the ball massage video that was also posted. I hope you have a great day. Thanks for joining me.